guys, I wanted to hop on here really quick. I am up feeding the sheep their winter supplement. I just did a video on it last week, or earlier this week. They're following me. But what we're doing for our winter supplement for our sheep, today, normally they get alfalfa hay, but they got alfalfa pellets today. But I want to hop on and just really quickly go over why we chose Katahdin Hair Sheep for our foundation of our flock. So when we were getting into sheep, we listened to a lot of Greg Judy videos and stuff. And if you listen to any of those kind of people, Katahdins are very well known for, and St. Croix and stuff, their parasite resistance. And we wanted, sorry, I was thinking I'm gonna have to do another video over that, kind of like setting up your goals for your sheep. But in the foundation of what we wanted for our sheep, we wanted it to be very low maintenance. We didn't want to have to be bringing them down to the farm all the time and giving them wormer and, you know, trying to treat different things. So Katahdins are really well known for that. And that's why we ended up going with the Katahdins. There was also some reputable breeders that were pretty close to us. So it just made sense for us to go with Katahdins. Since then though, we have decided that we are going to switch over to a breed called an Australian White. And so that's what our ram is right here. I'll be doing another video just on Australian Whites and kind of giving you guys the background on how this guy came from an embryo in Australia and was implanted into a ewe, a Katahdin ewe, all the way in Alabama. And then how he ended, it's so goofy, how he ended all the way up on our farm. So, I'll just leave it at that, and just a quick video on why Katahdins, why hair sheep. I mean, I could go on and on about why hair sheep, but that will have to be saved for another video. So, make sure you guys are subscribed and like this video so other people can see it, and we will see you guys in the next one. Have a great weekend. Bye, guys.